Good evening, everybody. I'm Bella. This is the news and the weather presented in English and Portuguese. We are here since 2014 to talk with this beautiful community. And here they are, our picks for this week, starting tonight, Monday, February 4th, 2019. Public briefed on PFAS contamination. Here, a brief to our viewers on the MEV Airport's PFAS investigation and proposed remediation plans. Last update. Aqui uma breve para os nossos telespectadores sobre a investigação PFAS do aeroporto de Martha's Vineyard e suas propostas de planos de remediação. Última atualização. After initial tests, 26 wheels on the roads by the airport have tested positive for PFAS, with 13 of them being at or above the 70 parts per trillion guideline set by environmental regulators. Many of the homes are getting bottled waters, while the Martha's Vineyard Airport consultant works on plans to install carbon-based filtration systems for some of the properties. Após os testes iniciais, 26 poços nas estradas próximas ao aeroporto de Martha's Vineyard tiveram testes positivos para o PFAS, com 13 deles estando em ou acima da diretriz de 70 partes por trilhão, definida por reguladores ambientais. Muitas das casas estão recebendo água engarrafada, enquanto o consultor do aeroporto trabalha em planos para instalar sistemas de filtragem baseados em carbono para algumas das propriedades. PFAS is a chemical compound used for fighting Class B petroleum fires, often involved in aircraft. Ron Myricki of Tetra Tech said the chemical is mixed with water and other compounds, then administered as a foam that smoothers petroleum fires. O PFAS é um composto químico usado no combate a incêndios de petróleo da classe B, geralmente envolvido em aeronaves. Well, in the local impact expected to be significant, airport expansion sees public backlash. An early stage plan to significantly expand the terminal and parking facilities at the Martha's Vineyard Airport saw backlash from island residents at a public hearing on Thursday evening. And in the hearing, people saw as well detailed questions about both the need for and environmental impacts for more than doubling the size of the airport terminal and adding another 550 parking spaces. Um plano inicial para expandir significativamente o terminal e as instalações de estacionamento no aeroporto de Martha's Vineyard causou uma grande reação nos moradores da ilha em uma audiência pública na noite da quinta-feira. Na audiência também foram apresentadas questões detalhadas sobre a necessidade e os impactos ambientais de dobrar, que é uma proposta, o tamanho do terminal do aeroporto e adicionar mais de 550 vagas para estacionamento. Circulando, circulating. Let's get in locally to learn more. Our interview tonight is with Simon Atten from Morning Glory Farm. We were talking about composting and why we need to do it. A entrevista da noite é com Simon Atten, da fazenda Morning Glory Farm. E nós vamos falar sobre a produção de compostagem. What interview? Why do you think? Why we need to keep educating ourselves? May it will help you or inspire you. We are at Morning Glory Farm, talk with Simon Atten. Simon will help us understand why we composting. Hello, Simon.
Hi, Bella.
How are you?
I'm excellent, thank you.
Thank you for your time.
Glad to be here.
Simon, help us understand why we do composting.
Well, I think composting is very important. To me, it's two main reasons. One is to reduce the trash. People are putting things that can compost into the trash, and it makes more work for the trash, more weight, more cost, more pollution, and we can keep that here. And so the second reason is to make fertilizer and food for the earth. We're taking the food from the earth, and the remainder should go back to the earth. And it feeds the soil, so we don't have to buy in new fertilizers, new soils. It's those two reasons.
Is it easy to do in home?
Oh yes, absolutely. It's easy to do at home, but there's some simple rules to follow, and you want to make sure to keep it safe from animals and wildlife.
Simon, tell us about how we can learn from the event what to do with food waste during the winter. I know this event is happening within three-part series.
That's right. There's a lot of information to help you get composting at home. The Island Grown Initiative is hosting a series of workshops to learn about composting. The first was held at the West Tisbury Library last week. More compost workshops will be happening this winter. I would get in touch with the Island Grown Initiative to find out more.
How the farm, Morning Glory Farm, can help us to compost?
We're big composters. We've been composting for 30 years here, and we use the farm compost on the farm to grow our vegetables. We have an open compost pile that's open from dawn to dusk, 7 days a week, during the season that the Morning Glory Farm is open, May through December. And landscapers can bring their trucks of leaves and grass and garden clippings, and you can bring your pail from home and dump it on our compost pile. We'll manage it. We'll make good quality compost, and we'll use it on our fields. You can just bring it to here to our farm on Meshacket Road. The pile is right under our windmill. And if you're interested in our rules and what we accept, you can go to our website at morninggloryfarm.com.
Thank you, Simon, very much for your time and your knowledge.
Oh, happy to help.
Questions like that. Can I compost during the winter? Posso produzir compostagens durante o inverno? And some techniques. Go to the webs. In local Island Grown Initiative, Morning Glory Farm, in West Tisbury Library, checking in the next composting workshop. There is no need to stop composting during the winter and make a friendly trash environment. What a beautiful community. Obrigado. Obrigado, Simon, pelas informações. E para você agora, começando News from Brazil, Brazil News. A notícia é retirada da matéria de Marina Wenzel, de Basileia, Suíça, para a BBC Brasil. Update em 28 de janeiro de 2019, Brumadinho. Desastre deve ser investigado como crime, diz a ONU. O rompimento da barragem de Brumadinho deve ser investigado como um crime, afirmou a BBC News Brasil, Baskut Tunkak, o relator especial das Nações Unidas para Direitos Humanos e Substâncias Tóxicas. Esse desastre exige que seja assumida responsabilidade pelo que deveria ser investigado como um crime. O Brasil deveria ter implementado medidas para prevenir colapsos de barragens mortais e catastróficas após o desastre da Samarco de 2015, disse Tunkak, em referência à tragédia de Mariana. Segundo o relator da ONU, as autoridades brasileiras deveriam ter aumentado o controle ambiental, mas foram completamente ao contrário, ignorando alertas da ONU e desrespeitando os direitos humanos dos trabalhadores e moradores da comunidade local. Os esforços contínuos do Brasil para enfraquecer as proteções para comunidades e trabalhadores que lidam com substâncias e resíduos perigosos mostram um desrespeito insensível pelos direitos de comunidades e dos trabalhadores na linha de frente, disse o especialista. Até a terça-feira, no dia 29 de janeiro, haviam sido confirmadas 84 mortes, das quais 35 corpos tinham sido identificados. Pelo menos 276 vítimas seguiam desaparecidas. For your understand, Brumadinho, disaster must be investigated as a crime, says United Nations on the bbc.com/portuguese/Brazil News. Brumadinho dam disruption should be investigated as a crime. United Nations Special Rapporteur for Human Rights and Toxic Substance, Baskut Tunkak, told BBC News Brazil. This disaster requires responsibility for what should be investigated as a crime. Brazil should have implemented measures to prevent the collapse of deadly and catastrophic dams after the Samarco disaster of 2015, said Tunkak, referring to Mariana's tragedy in Minas Gerais. According to the United Nations reporter, Brazilian authorities should have increased environmental control, but were completely the opposite, ignoring United Nations warnings and disrespecting the human rights of workers and residents of the local community. Continued efforts in Brazil to weaken protections for communities and workers dealing with hazardous substance and waste show a disregard for the rights of communities and workers at the front line, said the expert. As of Tuesday, January 29, 84 deaths had been confirmed, of which 35 bodies had been identified. At least 276 victims were still missing. E em notícias atualizadas, tragédia em Brumadinho, medo de rompimento de barragem, tira sono em outra cidade mineira. Depois da tragédia de Brumadinho, moradores de Congonhas, em Minas Gerais, passaram a semana apreensivos, com um olho no noticiário e o outro na barragem da Companhia Siderúrgica Nacional, a CSN, que paira sobre sua cidade, 5 vezes maior do que a que rompeu. What a challenger! February brings the weather challenger. More challenger. Fevereiro traz mais desafios ao tempo. Assista the weather forecast. The weather challenger. Hoje, noite de segunda-feira, tonight, Monday, formação de neblina, tempo nublado e mínimas nos 40 graus. Tuesday, terça-feira, mostly cloudy, then becoming sunny, with a high near 54 west wind in the morning. Tempo nublado e ensolarado, se tornando ensolarado com máximas nos 54 graus e ventos vindo pelo oeste de manhã. Tuesday night, tempo bom para terça-feira, com mínimas nos 31 graus e ventos pelo oeste, entre 11 a 14 milhas por hora. Mostly clear, with a low around 31 west wind, 11 to 14 miles per hour. Quarta-feira, Wednesday sunny, with a high near 37, north wind 8 to 10 miles per hour, becoming east in the afternoon, tempo ensolarado, com máximas nos 37 graus e ventos à tarde vindo pelo leste. Noite de quarta, Wednesday night, noite de quarta-feira, rain mainly after 11 p.m., low around 33, southeast wind. Chuvas antes das 23 horas e mínimas nos 33 graus e ventos pelo sudoeste. Thursday, quinta-feira, rain likely mainly before 10 a.m., cloud with a high near 44. Previsão de chuvas antes das 10 da manhã e o tempo nublado com máximos nos 44 graus. Thursday night, previsão de chuvas com tempo nublado e mínimas nos 40 graus. Friday, a chance of rain, cloud with a high near 48. Sexta-feira, com previsão de chuvas e temperaturas máximas nos 48 graus. Definitely it's always a challenger. Definitivamente. Enjoy the upcoming events and our video message. Na nossa mensagens em vídeo. Open mic at Island Music every other Tuesday in February. Fevereiro tem open mic. Let's go there. Vamos lá. This week at Pathways, Cleveland House Poets, Tuesday, February 5th. Ocean Film Shorts, Friday, February 8th. Soup Super, updating, Friday, this Friday, February 8th. 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. at Grace Episcopal Church. Also check with Good Musical Review. Musical Review back at Playhouse in Vina Haven. What's your message? Força e luz para aprender. Obrigado, Simon.
Simon Atten, that is a word can save the world. Give us that one.
Community. Appreciate your community. Live in your community. Buy vegetables from your community. Contribute to your community. Go to your community gatherings. Talk to each other. This is how we can save the world.
Thanks to Alsters, the National Adeline Christopher's beautiful image background, MVTV special thanks to Carl Holt, Martha's Vineyard Savings Bank, Martha's Vineyard Cultural Council, and Chronics Market. Thank you all for all your support. We are on Facebook as well. Follow us and like us on Facebook. Connect with us at Planet Bella TV on YouTube channel. You can help supporting local news. The news and the weather with Bella since 2014. Connecting communities. Valentine's Day is coming! Que positive. Yes, indeed. Ciao, ciao for now. I see you next.